and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Jay Aldi, and today we are in our 1.18 Let's Play world. And boy, do I have updates for you. Updates and upgrades, kind of. So, I want to bring your attention. Oh yeah, of course it starts raining right when I come outside. But I did expand our wheat field, and I put... Ooh, it's raining. It's thunderstorming. I want to see if our lightning rods catch anything. Let's wait out here. In the safety of our door well. Yay, it did it! That was fun. Okay, now we go to bed. Okay, so... Like I was trying to say, look, it looks crispy. Okay, maybe not. I thought it looked crispy. So I expanded our wheat field, as we saw, and I added some flowers and like sugarcane kind of everywhere. So it's a little bit more lively. Yeah, and I really expanded out the wheat field. And I added some lanterns in here because I wanted a little bit of light, and it was really dark over there. So I just added little lights, and it's kind of cute that you can see them because it kind of adds a little bit of like a fairy garden feel. But yeah, I kind of have like my sugar cane and everything. I have flowers down here. So it adds just a little bit more life. I scattered a little bit of the flowers kind of down the hill, and once I get more, I want to put it more down the hill so it looks a little bit more like lively and not just like grass everywhere. I haven't done anything different with the villager trading hall or anything like that, or the villagers, to be honest. The only thing that I did get done was a little bit of the iron farm building. It looks a little bit better in my opinion. It looks better than what it did before. So this is what it looks like now. I changed the roofing so it's not like just a triangle. I know you can't really see it. And then I added these cute little lamp posts. I think I'm gonna make like a lamp post design and kind of scatter them throughout the village and then up here as well. But for now, they're just on like little walls and then just a lantern. And then I put some greenery and flowers, and I bone mealed the floor. Sorry, I bone mealed the grass. I ran out of bone meal on this side, but honestly, no one's gonna go over there. So yeah, so this is the front of the building. I think it looks better than what it did before. I just extended out this like trim area, so it looks a little less flat. This has an iron door. I don't want to put a pressure plate here because I don't want like zombies or anything to go up into the iron farm area. I just realized I could put buttons there and I don't have to put pressure plates. I'll add that later. I don't really use the front door anyways. So this is the door that I use. It's just really cute. I want to section off these rooms here, so I've begun doing that. But in this room is kind of, this is the first room off of the main, like the front door basically. So this I put as our little like working shop kind of thing, kind of like iron, like forge, kind of like it's a little forge. I should have put like fire in here actually, because you need like hot things to forge things. Anyways, so I just kind of put this big table here with a crafting table in the middle. I put these barrel or these chests here for iron from the iron farm, so I don't have to go all the way up there if I need iron. So that's what these little chests are for, and the barrels are kind of hidden around the area for. Of course, throughout the series, I'm probably going to have more iron than I could ever need. So I will, in the other rooms here, I will just put more barrels so we can put more iron in those. But yeah, I don't know. I just really like this area. I think it looks really cute. So I kind of wanted it to be cluttered like this. And I put paintings on the wall because the walls looked really boring. So I just had to put something. But I put like shelving here with flowers and like potted plants. And yeah, I really like it. This is our butter knife. Oh, my dog just straight up fell off the couch. I don't know what happened. Yeah, I think he's fine. Anyways, this is the magic spoon of beetroot soup. I don't know. I was bored and I just wanted to do that. Anyways, this is the Iron Farm area. I don't really plan on putting much things in here, mainly because I don't want it to be spawnable. Like, I don't want iron golems to spawn up here, but I did put a little platform up here so it's easier for us to grab the iron and everything like that. I also fixed this side of the iron farm, if you guys remember. I accidentally let one villager escape, so he's back up there now. Well, not the same one because the other one died, but I got another one up here, so now this side works perfectly fine. And now we are getting double the iron. Again, I don't think we'll need this much iron ever. But it's better to be looking at it than looking for it, you know? I also changed the stained glass windows into just regular glass windows, and it looks so much brighter in here. Like, it doesn't look like a dungeon anymore. So with all that updating out of the way, I hope you guys enjoyed our little like iron farm area a little bit better. It doesn't look as bad in my opinion. Obviously there's room for improvements always, but it looks better and it looks more lively and it looks more like it's meant to be here rather than just kind of put here, you know? Oh, I also made an ender chest. I don't know why I did it off camera. I literally didn't need it right then and when I made it, but I made an ender chest. So I was thinking in today's video, we should go exploring again. I know the last couple videos have been pretty building heavy, so I thought it would be a really good idea to try and go exploring today, see what we can find. And honestly, there's a lot of places that I haven't explored yet. The area over there where the village is that I stole the villagers from, I haven't gone over there because I had no idea that there was a village there. So I think we should go like diagonally this way and kind of see what we kind of find. I also really want to find a desert. Okay, let's go exploring! Oh, we should have brought a saddle so then we could tame a horse and then not have to worry about our food so much, but that's okay. Maybe if we find a saddle in the wild, like in a chest somewhere, then maybe we can tame a horse and see, you know, if we can find a fast one that's worth it. I didn't know we were so close to this many jungles. Like, I could never find a jungle and we would have to travel like thousands of blocks away to find a jungle. But now I have jungles on every side of me, I think. This looks so pretty. Like, look at that. Wow! Imagine like making a little like a little hut here in the water. Oh, that'd be so cute. Ooh, there's a pillager outpost over here. I think we should go and take them down. Especially now that I have a bow with me, I think it will be easier. Oh, okay, let's set our spawn right here just in case. I'm always nervous going into these. I know it's not that hard, but like still, you know, just hearing those arrs is just terrifying. Let's try and go up these stairs properly. Oh, there's literally no one up here. That's funny. Well, there's nothing really here. I will take the carrots though, because I'm kind of low on carrots at back home. So, all right, well, that was fun. Is this snow? Snow way! But yeah, we haven't come across this yet before, so this is fun. Let's go see if there's a little, like, village. Thank you. Is that another ruined... Oh, I think it is another ruined portal. Okay, so we'll go that way. This doesn't seem to look like anything. Just ice spikes. Let's take this. Thank you so much. A village! Yay! I love these types of villages. I think they're really cool. Probably mainly because I haven't come across them a lot in like other worlds. So it's just kind of like unique. Just like how jungles used to be for me. But now I see them everywhere. Ah, beetroot soup. Oh, I love nitwits. Hi. Wow. That would have been awesome. Early game. I don't need it. Actually, you know what we could do? Because this is almost a full set. We can put this in our ender chest. And if we ever die, it can just be there. And then we don't have to worry about it too much. Okay, well, I think that's all. So let's figure out where we have to go again. Yeah, we're going the right way, brothers. We did it! Well, it's an azalea tree! Should we go down? We haven't found like a lush cave this way. Like following the rooted dirt. We should go down. Follow the rooted dirt. Yay! That scared me. Wait, okay, where's the spore blossoms? Let's get all the spore blossoms we can from in here. Okay. Oh, that's a mine shaft up there too. Maybe we do explore a little. I don't know. Oh, why did that... what was I expecting? What was I expecting? Oh, right off the bat. Cave spider spawner and a chest. Oh, that was sneaky. Hey. Are they always that creepy? No. That's so funny. Okay, so I let some of the iron that I found down in the mine shaft, I let that smelt a little bit, and then I was kind of sick and tired of exploring the mine shaft, so I decided to dig out. I just have to figure out which way I'm going. But yeah, the mine shaft, I just kind of got bored and tired of doing that, and I don't like having the feeling that I'm being like followed, you know, like in real life, in games, it's the same thing. So I don't really like going in like caves and stuff like that by myself. So yeah, we're just gonna stick to above ground overworld exploring. I still really want to find a desert. It seems like there's no desert biome in this world. All there seems to be are jungles and birch forests. Oh, look at the little guy go! Look at him go! Yay! Oh my, he angry. Okay guys, we have an acacia village. Or savanna village, lol. Nice! Starting off good. Ooh, okay. Better. Alright, well, there wasn't that much stuff in that village, so I guess we'll just keep going. Ooh, there's a swamp here. Now, I do want to find some of those flowers that only spawn in the swamp. So let's go hunting for those. I was just about to give up, but then I saw some in the middle here, so... Let's grab them. I don't even know what they're called. Let's see. A blue orchid. I'm very surprised I said that word right the first time. Ooh, an abandoned abandoned shipwreck. Let's go see. Okay, so we found a buried treasure map in that. So we'll go ahead and look for it. It's a little off course, but that's okay. This is fun. Oh, there it is. Wow, a diamond! Our ender chest, I think, is full. And our inventory is almost full, not really. Like, we can get rid of this sand here. And I do want to keep the bucket just in case we find an axolotl. I say we keep going. Honestly, like, let's just keep going. It's fine. I was so hopeful that this was a desert. But it isn't. It's just another beach. I'm so upset. Like, where? What do I have to do to find a desert? Like, I just want to know. I just want to know. Like, how hard is it to find a desert? Also, there's, like, so many dark oak forests and so many birch forests. And so many jungles. Like, is this the same for everyone's 1.18 world? Or is it just me? Because, like, this is really weird. I have spotted a taiga village in the distance. And I'm really excited because, as you guys know, these are my favorite types of village. And I'm really excited that I found it. I literally just saw, like, from the corner of my eye, I saw it. And I was like, yeah, it's a little bit off course, but I will go to it. And I think, unless I was imagining it. No, it's right here. Okay, sweet, 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 sweet. Usually these ones have pretty decent loot. LOL. As there's no chest in the first house. Ooh, I want to take the purple bed. Yay, I have a purple bed now. Oh. Okay, well, I stand corrected. They just have pumpkin pie. These, like, houses always make me giggle because there's always some, like, a little, like, basement one. But, like, it's always, like, terrible, you know? Like, it's just, like, an afterthought. I don't know why I keep setting my spawn point all the time. I get so paranoid. Oh! He was jumping on the bed. That's cute. Okay, well, there wasn't much in this village. So, I'm just going to keep going. And hopefully find a stupid desert, you know? We made it to a flower field. Oh, this is perfect. I needed flowers. I know our inventory is like almost empty, but I needed these flowers so badly. So I'm going to grab all the flowers that my little inventory can gather because we desperate. So I've been running and running and running and running, right? Right. And I've been trying to find a desert for this long, for episodes. We've been looking for deserts. You want to know what I found? We found a mesa. We found a mesa before we found a desert. Now, I don't know about you, but I rarely come across mesa biomes. Very, very rarely do I come across mesa biomes. And I find a mesa biome before I find a desert. I am very annoyed. I mean, it's really cool that we found this mesa, and I'm going to write down the coordinates for it. Because, you know, maybe if we ever get an elytra, we can come back here and then, or we can even set up another portal here. And then, we can just mine some mesa stuff. I don't know what's in here, like terracotta. But I'm going to explore. Maybe I'll try and find one of those like above ground mine shafts, abandoned mine shaft. And but then other than that, we'll keep going. But the water here is so blue. There's actually a lot of, like, lush caves here, though. Because there's an azalea tree right there. And I see one. Well, I saw one over there. Oh, there's one right there, too. Wow. Everything but a desert. Yeah! Yay! We found a desert! We are 10,000 blocks. It's abandoned. That's okay. I wasn't here for a village anyways. I was just here for a desert. But yeah, 10,000 blocks we have traveled in a diagonal direction. Yep. Just for this. And then there's a coral reef too. Wow. Maybe we can find an axolotl. I feel like I'm saying that weird. Axolotl. No, I think that's... I don't know. Axolotl. I think that's how you say it, to be honest. I don't really know. My inventory is very full. Anyways, let's grab an axolotl. Or we can... Pufferfish. Ow. I just wanted the advancement. Oh, I forgot drown can spawn in here still. Until they start smacking us with the trident, we're okay. We should be okay. We're good. So I found a desert. I found a mesa biome. And we're also like 10,000 blocks away from the house. I think we should maybe head back to the house. Because it's been a long journey. Your girl, her little legs, they're tired. So I think it's about time that we should go home. Okay, guys, I found a horse and it actually is at a pretty good speed. Like, look at this. Woo! It doesn't actually look that fast, but it is way faster than my running. So I think we'll keep him at least until the jungle here. Uh-oh. Oh, man. No. I just found a good horse, too. Ooh, good job. Okay, we'll figure it out. This horse goes so fast, I can't even, like, tell. Like, I can't even tell. You know what? I'm just gonna cut our losses here. Thanks so much, horsey. I hope you have a good life. Bobbing up and down in the water. Served me well. All right, let's go to this taiga biome and then we will sleep. Hopefully I can make it before mobs start spawning. I think I can. Maybe we should get our bed and our hot bar. Oh, also, I'll show you guys when I, you know, sleep and stuff, but I made a new skin. And I'm very proud of it because I've never made like a Minecraft skin before. So this is my little character. I think she's so cute. So this is the back of her. She has little overalls on. I've never worn overalls in my life, but I just couldn't figure out how to make it like look a little bit more interesting, you know? And then this is the front, which is so cute. Also, I realized that there's like a whole bunch of like darkness in between my arms. I don't think I can change that. Look at me. I'm so cute. I love it so much. I think you guys will have to let me know if you like this skin or not. Anyways, that's my new skin. I just wanted to have like my own skin and not use someone else's creation. Okay, so we have to go about 600 blocks more this way. And then we can start going the other way. I see a little village off to the side here, so we're just gonna go check it out. Probably nothing good in there, but you know, I don't want to miss anything, you know? So we always have to go check it out. Also, it's becoming nighttime, so we may as well just sleep in the village too. What an interesting entrance to a village house. Love that. Of course, take the bell. Why do we take the bell? I don't know. Okay, let's go check out the villager outpost, or the pillager outpost. My bad. Thank you. wasn't even worth it. Actually, I need carrots. So we're gonna take the carrots. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have strolled on into Elsa's kingdom, also known as the Ice Spikes biome. This is actually a really cool biome. I think it'd be really cool to build here. I'm not saying me to build here, but I'm just saying, like, in general, it would be kind of cool to have a build in, like, the Ice Spikes biome. This is kind of, like, my worst fear, just being, like, stuck under like, ice. When would I ever be stuck underneath ice? Who knows? You guys, we finally made it home. Oh, look at this. Look, it's the Iron Farm. Wow, I miss this place because I didn't spend a million hours on it before. No, but I still missed it. Oh, have I missed this house, this area? Wow, we did it, everyone. And we didn't die, which I'm very happy about, obviously. But let's go ahead and set our spawn point just in case. Well, everyone, I think that'll have to do for today's episode. It's a long one, so I hope you guys enjoyed and stuck around till the end. And I hope you enjoyed the shenanigans that we got up to. I don't know, I really like exploring, so I hope you enjoyed the exploring episode as much as I did. I'm now realizing that my head looks very small for my helmet, so I might have to go ahead and change some things in my skin, but it's cute. But thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, see you later. Bye!